As I told in the last class, for every IoT access technology, we will be discussing following the elements. It may be standardization and alliance that indicates who has designed these things, who is managing these technology, all those things. Next, physical layer of these technologies, MAC layer of the IoT technologies, and which topology it supports, and security related aspects, and also if any other competitive technologies are present, that will be discussed. We'll start with the first one, IEEE 802.15.4. See, this is a wireless technology for low cost and low data rate devices, especially they are the constrained devices. This is a technology for a constrained devices that can be used in the normal environment or in the remote environment. So we use IEEE 802.15.4 in the normal environment. It may be in the home automation, it may be in the agricultural field, it may be in the industry for a shorter to medium range communication. We use this for shorter to medium range communication. It can be used in the remote applications also. It may be in the forest, under the ocean, anywhere. For remote application also, I can use this technology for communication. See, now what we are discussing is various communication technologies available for IoT. So this IEEE 802.15.4, the best example for this is ZigBee. Hope you all heard about this technology, ZigBee technology. Okay, and it has a very good protocol stack, and it remains simple and flexible. So it is designed by a group called as IEEE 802.15 task group 4. It has some very low data rate. It can transfer the data in BPS, bits per second. Maximum it can transfer the data at some kbps level. Always it will be at the BPS rate. So bits per second rate. So that's why we call it as low data rate physical layer and MAC layer. Okay. So here it was initially specified during the 2003, then later versions were released. So under this, the main technology is ZigBee. Okay, so we'll see these things later. It may be used in the building automation, home automation, healthcare, and even in the remote application, we can use ZigBee. Along with this ZigBee, we have two more things, 6LoWPAN and ZigBee IP. See, before going to ZigBee IP, 6LoWPAN is an IPv6 adaptation layer defined by Internet Engineering Task Force. See, this is an additional layer attached to the network layer for IoT applications. We attach the 6LoWPAN for network layer in the IPv6 packet in order to support the proper network layer functionalities. We'll see this in detail later. Next, we have ZigBee IP. Again, it is a supporting layer or network layer entity for the ZigBee protocol. Okay. We'll move directly to the ZigBee now. See, ZigBee comes under the category IEEE 802.15.4. It is not designed by a single entity, single person or a single firm. It is a product of the joint venture from 400 companies. They made an alliance called as ZigBee Alliance. They worked together. Even Wi-Fi is not from a single company or not from a single person. Many industries work together to design this Wi-Fi technology and also to standardize these Wi-Fi technologies. So every evolution under this Wi-Fi technology is a outcome of the giant venture from many companies. Similarly, for a Zigbee, many companies made one alliance. Almost more than 400 companies worked together to frame this technology called Zigbee and also to standardize these Zigbee technologies. See, I can't use Bluetooth and all in the constrained environments. So the better solution is Zigbee for IoT. So this is designed by a group of more than 400 companies and they have standardized everything in it. So we'll not worry about these design part tonight. So it was started in some year and many updations were done. We'll not worry about this thing. See, the Zigbee focus on small data transmission. So it will be in the range of bits per second, maybe temperature reading, humidity reading, or it may be some simple values. These data can be transmitted through Zigbee. So maybe controlling the lightings, thermostats, and security functions in the house, so home automation application, like that we can use. Just for sending simple, small data, we can, and the two for a smaller range, medium range, less than a few hundreds of meters, we can use Zigbee protocol. See, it has a low-end physical layer and MAC layer. As I told, for every technology, we will be discussing who has designed this technology, how its physical layer works, how it MAC layer works. Why we will not discuss other layers? Because all these things comes under physical layer and data link layer. So whether it's a wired or wireless technology, it will be at the physical layer and the data link layer. So we will not discuss about the network layer. They are common for any wireless technology, whether it is a network layer, transport layer, or application layer, is common for any kind of communication technology. We will concentrate only on these physical layers and MAC layer, as these technologies belongs to these two layers only. So you all know that MAC stands for Medium Access Control Layer. It is a sublayer of data link layer. Okay. See here, it also provides something called as security layer under this MAC layer in order to provide security. It uses AES algorithm and all. We'll see the security layer in detail later. Okay. Next is, this is the Zigbee protocol stack. We concentrate on P layer and MAC layer. Other than that, it provides, see, these two are common for any of the IEEE 802.15.4 technology. It may be for Zigbee or other technologies. Physical layer is there, MAC layer is there. Above that, these two layers are specific to the Zigbee technology. Provide very good security layer and also support for applications. We'll see them in detail. It has something called as Zigbee IP. In order to provide a proper support to the network layer and especially IP protocol or IP version 6 protocol, we have something called as Zigbee IP. See, okay, it provide very low bandwidth. It can't provide more bandwidth and it consume very less power, and also it support cost effective communication. Here, what is this cost effective meaning? It's not in terms of money, it in terms of network resources. It may be power consumption, it may be processing power, it may be data rate like that, or battery usage. It provide cost effective communication when I connect smarter objects. So low bandwidth, low power, and also cost effective communication. For this purpose, we use Zigbee IP protocol attached to the Zigbee. It has something like this. There is a 2006 release version of physical layer, MAC layer. Then we have IPv6 supporting layer. We call it a 6 low pan. This is IPv6 low power personal area network adaptation layer. Then we have all other supports, IPv6, ICMP, and RPL relay, IPv6 routing protocols will be there, UDP, TCP, then ZigBee, IP will be there. We'll start with physical layer. See, in the physical layer, hope you all remember these terms, few terms what you studied in the data communication. DSSS, direct sequence spread spectrum. We have FHSS and DSSS. We studied that in the data communication. This ZigBee or IEEE 802.15.4 technology operates at 2.4 gigahertz to various subfrequencies in industry, scientific, medical bands, ISM band. ISM comes under unlicensed bands. Under this, it provides various options for physical layer. So here, it makes use of direct sequence spread spectrum. It will not use FHSS. It uses direct sequence spread spectrum for modulations. It provides three options. One is 2.4 gigahertz frequency range. This is for wireless communication. So frequency range will be under at 2.4 gigahertz with 16 channels. 16 channels are there for communication, operating at 2.4 gigahertz, and it supports the data rate of about 250 kbps. Also, it provides one more option, sub options, that is 915 megahertz with 10 channels in it, 10 simultaneous channels in it, and each provides up to 40 kbps data rate. And it provides one more frequency range, it can provide 868 megahertz one channel with data rate only 20 kbps. Depending on the application, we can either choose any one of these options available for the transmission. See, remember one thing, whether it is for ZigBee or whether it is for Bluetooth or for Wi-Fi that we use in our home, everything make use of 2.4 gigahertz band only. So all these technology operates at these frequency bands, 2.4 gigahertz frequency band, please remember. So, and even though it has three options among these things, this is more popular worldwide. Along with these things, it make use of phase shift keying. So you all know these things, right? Digital to analog conversion techniques. How digital data can be converted into analog. So we need modulations and demodulation. We have studied phase FSK, ASK, and TSK, all those things in data communication. Digital to analog conversion technique. So we use PSK, that to quadrature PSK. So there are four levels here, four unique levels. So four different phases are there. So we can send four bits simultaneously, four different phases are there. This is quadrature, that to offset quadrature PSK, phase shift keying. So it supports this for digital to analog conversion. Say at the device side, data will be in the digital format. This needs to be converted into analog for transmission. For this, either it uses OQPSK, which provides very good reliability functionalities. Other than that, it also supports binary PSK, phase shift keying. Only it has two phases, either the phase one or phase two. Then it also supports amplitude shift keying, so ASK. either we can use OQPSK devices, or we can use BPSK, or we can use ASK for digital to analog conversion. So it supports all these things at the physical layer. Next, physical layer format. So for the ZigBee protocol, or IEEE 802.15.4, the data, whatever you send, it will be sent in this frame format or a physical layer format. So there will be a preamble. So it is like some synchronization bits. It may be alternative zeros and ones. It indicates that data is coming. After this, something is coming. Okay, it is a synchronization. In order to make, or in order to achieve the synchronization between sender and receiver, we send some synchronization bits. We call this as preamble. Next, we have delimiters. So it indicates from here actual frame starts. Then length of the frame. Then the data. Your data will be stored here. Can you see this? It supports only 128 bytes of data. At a time, you can transfer only 128 bytes of data. Very simple. Data can be transmitted. You can't send a bigger data using these technologies. So this is the physical layer format. I repeat, we have preamble. This is used for synchronization between the sender and the receiving device. And there will be a delimiter. It indicates after this, your actual frame starts. And we have a length and then the actual data. Then we'll move to the next layer, which is MAC layer. See, MAC is medium access control, or it is a sublayer of data link layer. So it is above the physical layer. What it do? You take simple Wi-Fi as example. See, Wi-Fi routers will be sending the beacon messages to your device in order to show its existence. Beacon message means something, a simple message which indicates I am still alive. I am present here, I am present here, I am present here. When you receive this beacon message, so your mobile will show there is one Wi-Fi router available for connection. If you want to see that Wi-Fi router for a longer time, so if you want to connect to that, first you should receive a beacon message. If you don't receive a beacon message for some time, then that Wi-Fi router name will be removed from your mobile or something. So you can't see that. Again, when you receive a beacon message, you can see the name of that Wi-Fi router. Similarly, the ZigBee also issues the beacon message in order to prove its existence in the network. So every device will keep on exchanging its beacon messages. And also it provides something called as PAN association. What is this PAN? PAN stands for personal area network. We can form a group of devices connected to each other. So a device can attach to this smaller network or be detached from these smaller networks. Association and deassociation. Also, MAC layer provides security, and also it provides reliable communication between the two devices. There are four different frames format under the MAC layer. One is data frame. This is used for transmitting the data. Then there is a format for beacon message exchange also. Once data or beacon is sent, once receiver receives this, it sends the acknowledgement using the acknowledgement frame. And for any connection related, for any management purpose or for any controlling operation, we use control frame. See, you are familiar with all these terms in the networking, data communication and CN classes. So it has four kind of messages. One is data frame, use it for data transmission. Beacon frame, this is for proving its existence. Then acknowledgement frame, after receiving any control information or data, receiver will send this acknowledgement. And there is something called as command frame. This is used for exchanging the control information. Maybe network setup for association, deassociation, or any other debugging related things, we use this command frame. So in general, this is the format for Mac frames. There will be a preamble again. So it is used for synchronization between the sender and the receiver. Then there will be a delimiter. Then there is a frame length and this PSPU. See, we saw the same thing in the previous slide also. Now I am expanding the same thing. Under this data, we have so many subframes. First one is frame control. This is used for proper coordinations, controlling the frame. Then there is a sequence number. It is used for organizing the frames in a sequence, one after the other. Suppose they have formed one group, small group of nodes. Suppose a PAN is formed, personal area network is formed. There will be a one unique ID attached to it. Say I want to send data from one PAN to another PAN. Suppose there are 8 nodes deployed in some location. 3 nodes have formed one personal area network. There exists another 3 nodes which has formed their own personal area network. We have 2 more nodes at another personal area network. For each PAN, there will be one unique identifier. If you want to send the data from one PAN to the another PAN, you need this ID. So this is a destination PAN ID and this is a source PAN ID. Other than that, nodes, sender's address and receiver's address. And there will be a data, and this is used for error detection, frame set sequence. So this is the overall frame format of IEEE 802.15.4. So this is the preamble, start frame delimiter, frame length, then frame control, sequence number, destination PAN identifier, destination address, source PAN identifier, source address, frame payload, this is the data, and frame set sequence. Maximum, this can be 128 bytes. Under this, it can be of variable size. I can send only 1 byte also. I can send 10 bytes also. Okay. Any doubts still here? IEEE 802.15.4, or let us call ZigBee, supports star topology. It supports P2P topology, and also it supports mesh topology. We'll see how these topologies can be used and can be formed.